Hey, what's up, guys? I'm back here with another Top 10 Tuesday. I brought a special guest with me. I got ProcessHSK here in the building.
What's going on?
Yeah, man, if you want to go ahead and give them a quick little story about you, or let them know something about you.
Man, been back 10 years, co-founder of HSK, heavy in the Dunks, heavy in Air Maxes, been featured in probably everything you've ever thought about or read on. Plenty of banners hanging from the ceiling.
Yeah, man, I actually know this guy from there was a Facebook group going on back then. It was called What Did You Wear Today, and that's actually where I met this guy. I bought a pair of shoes from him. What shoes were they? I don't even know what shoes.
November Rain mitts.
I remember buying the shoes. I met him.
A long time ago.
Yeah. Made you meet me up at my old job. I used to work at Whataburger, and that's where we met. So, yeah, man.
Long time ago.
It's going to be a good top 10, so y'all stay tuned.
So, let's get it. All right, so my first pair is the House of Pain Canvas 80s that released in, I believe it was like 2008, 2007 at Concepts in Boston only. I got these off eBay. I don't remember the dude's name, but I actually like this pair for a few reasons. I love House of Pain. You know, everybody knows them for the song Jump Around. It's actually signed by Everlast, DJ Lethal, and Danny Boy, who are all the original House of Pain members. I'm also half Irish, so it does hold a special place. The Three Stripes, Canvas 80, Green Suede. It says Fine Malt Lyrics by the Third Stripe. On the back, it actually has the Irish flag. If you see it going around the shoe. I don't know if you can see it on the tongue, but it's got the House of Pain crest. And the insole, which I warned them, it actually has the House of Pain crest as well. It came with white alternate laces and orange laces. I either lost them or they walked off at a sneaker show. But this is like one of my favorite pairs of these, and I'm half Irish, so it helps. Second pair is a P-Rod 1 Elite. It's actually called the J-Rod. This is the first non-Jordan shoe to have the Jumpman on it. It's a Tinker designed Nike SB P-Rod 1. It's got the Jumpman here, the Jumpman on the tongue. It has the 13 embossed, like you see on the 13s. It's got that embossed on it. It's got the elephant print, like you see on the 3s. This is one of 500. So there's only 499 other ones of these in the world. This is a pink box series for all my Nike SB heads. This is probably my Air Max grill next to the Kid Robot Air Max ones. This is the Air Max 90 Warhawk. As you can see, it's got the sawtooth. It's actually done after the P-40 naval plane. And my dad was in the Navy, my grandfather was in the Navy. So when I saw this, it was like a grill. I don't think it released in Texas. It was originally called the G.I. Joe's. Back tab, it's got like the safety orange. Then the brown and all the panelings is actually like the forest green. Instead of the Air Max logo, it's got the navy star. It's got the sawtooth, like you see on the P-40 airplane. Translucent ice day. And the tightest part to me is if you take the two insoles and you put them to get them together, it actually makes the plane. So I bought those a few years ago, and then for way less than what they go for, like over a grand now, and I didn't pay nowhere near that. But yeah, this is the Air Max 90 Warhawk. All right, so my fourth shoe out of the top 10 is my Statue of Liberty Nike SB Dunk Dank Custom from 2010. I wanted him to originally do the DGK Statue of Liberty, where she's holding the AK, and he didn't for whatever reason. But he actually, if you wear the shoe, it's actually modeled after the Liberty, where she's green, but after like wear and seasoning, like she oxidizes underneath, and that's where the concept came from. Like the whole shoe was green, and underneath it was the brown, so to represent her oxidation. I knew people who took sandpaper to it. I knew dudes who went outside to the street and just threw it, and however they scratched, that's how they wore them. Dudes took sandpaper, like all kinds of things, but I actually wanted the theme. So he put Lady Liberty on the fox team, you know, through the back panel. She's actually on the tongue, and the shoe came like that. That's not custom. He did this on his own, which is cool. He actually put the American flag on the toe cap, and I was super happy when I got him back. It's still, so this is actually what the entire shoe looked like, and then when I got him back from him, he put Lady Liberty on there, and then D for Dank Custom, and then he had put the American flag on the toe cap. All right, so shoe number 5, I believe. This is the 2014 Lance Mountain Nike SB. It's actually a Jordan 1 upper with the Nike SB bottom. And the reason Lance Mountain did that is because a lot of the OG skaters skated Jordans and they really skated the Jordan 1. And so he took the concept from the Liberty where like the whole shoe was white and if he scuffed it, it revealed the black or the blue depending on where it was. So it's modeled after the Royal 1. And his concept was like they would skate shoes, beat them, tape them up. So he kind of went with that like destruction concept. So I actually gave these to Dank and I didn't see him until he posted on Instagram. So when everybody else saw him, I actually saw him. And on the Royal pair, he put Lance Mountain actually holding a Bottle School deck, which is Lance Mountain's logo. So this was all white. This was all white. And then the blue one to the Foxing, the blue one the Swoosh, the Royal, and then the Royal, you know, bottom, Royal laces. And then the black through the eye stays and the black through the toe box. And then the bread pair was obviously, he put MJ and it's got the picture. I don't remember what game it's from, but it's him where he's in the locker room holding the towel around his neck. That's actually what picture that is. The shoe was also all white. It's modeled after the bread, red shoestrings, red outsole, red Nike on the tongue. And it's the same concept. It's a Jordan 1 upper with the dunk bottom. And it's the same, it's the concept. It's actually got the Air Jordan logo on it. It's like the, it's like a standard one. And it's the same way. Like actually the shoe, it's probably like a better, idea of how the shoe was just all white and then this was white and then he did whatever he had to do to lift the color and it revealed the black. Okay, this is a black pair of the Lance Mountains. It was also just like Royals, it was all black. Except for this time, instead of putting like the image, he actually put Lance Mountain's Bottle School. So you can see it through the back paneling, through here. He put it all over the shoe, through the Swoosh, the D for the Dank Custom. Royal outsole, Royal shoestrings, Nike SB on the tongue tag, and actually it's pretty, we probably see it pretty legit, the Lance Mountain, the Bottle Skull on the toe cap. Did it on this side. This is the one that everybody acknowledges. This is the left shoe. It's obviously done after a bread, and I don't think a few people didn't notice, like Jordan actually released a year ago a Jordan shoe where it wouldn't scratch off, but it, through the Swoosh, it had like a red highlight, and all this is red, like the secondary leather was red, so it looked like the Lance Mountain, but it wasn't the Lance Mountain. It was actually a Jordan shoe to mimic what they had actually done for Nike SB. But this is the Lance Mountain Nike SB. On this one, he actually put the Wings logo through here. You can see it through the Swoosh. He actually centered it on the back, so it says Air Jordan perfectly across the back. I actually wear these a lot, but I wear them with shoe trees and they wear really well. So you can see the Air Jordan across the toe cap, Air Jordan, you can see. This is actually the only pair of these I've ever seen, at least a sample of it. This is actually Two Emily, Peace, Love, and Kicks, actually autographed by Clark Kent, the world's God's favorite DJ from the ATF crew. It says 112 and it's got the underscores. If you don't know what 112 is, it's actually the prefix for Brooklyn's zip code. So it's 112, whatever, 112, whatever. That's actually what the 112 stands for. This is a sample box, sample tag. So this is a sample 112 Air Max 1. And this is literally, I'm sure there's other pair out there. I'm not saying this is the only one. This is literally the only pair I've ever seen. The only major difference between this and the production, which I have and it's at home, is the elephant print or the cement. The grooves on the production pair aren't as predominant. They're a lot thinner. And you can see it whenever you see it. It doesn't look like much, but I can wear them both and you wouldn't tell, but if I put them next to each other, it's pretty obvious. But the only difference between the sample, this sample and the production pair is the size and the engraving of the elephant print, but that's the only difference. This is a 112 from, I believe they're from 2007, 2008, but this is the 112 pack, one of the original 112s. The original three 112s is a trainer, an Air Force One, and then the Air Max One. But this is it, and I love the 112s. I love the bolt. All this is, anything that's around here is 3M. Like the whole shoe is, it pops. The kindling between the production and the sample was the same, but yeah, I love Air Maxes and the color. I've seen people put black laces in them, but I prefer it with the bolt laces. All right, so this is my LeBron 7 grill. So I'm sure you've seen Kenny, ARG 420, Gen 88, like all the heavy hitters. Like we see that that boombox like hashtag, this is what they're talking about. It's BOM, this box, our boom gang. Like it's a code that Nike uses for their samples, and this is my boom, and this is the production code for this particular shoe. This is the LeBron 7 112. This is a friends and family. You had to either know Clark Kent or LeBron James himself to get one of these. This is the only size 12 and a half in the world. This is not the Dunkman. This is probably 50 pairs of Dunkman. It's got Volt 360 outsole, suede, Volt flywire, Volt swoosh, elephant print across the top, elephant print across the back, L23, on the tongue. It's got the 112 and then the telephone booth, 112 on the debris. Yeah, again, this is literally the only size 12 and a half in the world. And you had to know LeBron James or Clark to get it. Okay, and shoe number 9 is my grail, probably grail. This is my dunk grail for sure. It literally took me 10 years to track this shoe down. I won an eBay. The dude didn't message me back because I didn't meet his reserve. Told him I had whatever money he wanted. Didn't message me back. 2 years ago, I had a deal with a guy, and 2 days before I got my money, somebody offered him twice what I was gonna buy it for. So like, no hard feelings. I ain't mad at the dude because the guy got twice what he was gonna offer. But actually, in February, I got this along with my second pair of Heinekens, and this is the Nike SB What the Dunk. And you had to own a skate shop in 2007 to even get a pair, and it was a shoe done with the Nothing But the True skate video. And it's basically a concept of everything up until the Gold Box series that was hot. So like, it's got the City Series pigeon, it's got the Buck logo on the back, and I do not know all the shoes. Tiffany in the middle panel, the bottom of this one's actually the Oompa Loompas, tweed toe cap. So, I mean, it's just so many shoes. That's the Huff on this mid panel. And it's a beautiful shoe, and this is actually the shoe that started the What the What the LeBron, the What the Kobe's, any What the that's out there, this is actually the shoe that started it. On this one it says, yeah, this one actually says What the, and then on the left shoe actually says Dunk. So this is the right shoe for the What the Dunk. And this is the left side of the What the Dunk. Again, it's just everything that was hot until the Gold Box series. Supremes, I believe the Cali outsole, Lucky Tongue, Supreme, Ice Day, Unlucky 13s, the Cali Dunk, the Rays, Denims, Supreme Middle. A lot of people think this is a Tiffany. I think it's Metacom, actually. We had a discussion about this in the forum the other day. The denim, this shoe is gorgeous, and yeah, it cost me a pretty penny to get it, but it officially sent me into retirement. I told everybody when I got it, like, I was done, and well, I haven't bought anything since I bought this. And this is the insole. Okay, so normally these shoes come in a gray Fante box. The box will be gray. There won't be no marking on it. It'll just have the regular box sticker and they'll say Fante, and it'll have your size and like your product code. But we did these in 2011, where HSK is the only crew ever to go to New York as a crew, and we all went and did bespoke together. Like, we went in February, we had done a thing with Sneaks Up San Antonio where they pushed their show back with us to help us like get this done so we can unveil them at their show. So the 2 nights before the show was on a Sunday. Kirsten Moran, who was head of Nike ID in Beaverton, got on a plane and flew to Japan, picked up our shoes, met us at the W on the Riverwalk in San Antonio, and hand delivered us RV smokes. She paid for our bar tab. They left a camera guy from Nike, from Beaverton, there with us so they could record the unveiling. And that's why I have, my box wasn't ready. This is why I have this damn tote, because my box wasn't ready. Like, she literally flew on the Nike plane, went to Fante, the production company, picked up our beast folks, met us in San Antonio at the W, and hand delivered us our show. Like, everybody but the two people who had problems with their beast folks got these. The guys who actually had problems with their beast folks have Fante boxes. But this is why I have a container store box and a Nike Sportswear 21 Mercer sticker and not a Fante box. So before we went to Mercer, Akuma actually drew a bunch of Air Force One silhouettes, and I made like 100 copies at my job and passed them out to everybody. So this is my actual concept. It was gonna have 3M on the swoosh, 3M guts actually. The thing about now probably would have hurt my toe or hurt my feet. All the ice days were gonna be 3M. The tongue was gonna be 3M. This was gonna be blue outsole. The collar's cross stitching. This was supposed to be rubber, but when we actually got up there and I had the swatches in front of me, the rubber and the 3M didn't make sense. And they actually didn't look right. So I cut the elephant print out and I cut out the rubber and the collar stitching actually too. So when you do a bespoke, this is literally all you walk out with, is the swatches of the material you choose. So this is blue 3M, reverse nubuck, gray 3M, patent gray, a lighter gray, and this nice little Nike sportswear thing. This is my hang tag off the shoe, and you can literally put any color, any material, and any writing that'll fit inside this little block. I chose Heat Seakers, so that's the name of the crew, obviously. And that's also a blue 3M, and on the back it says Nike sportswear. There. So when you do a Nike bespoke, you get your own production code. So nobody can redo your shoe. Like, Nike would actually have to call me to okay somebody to redo my shoe. Like, you get your own production code, your own style code. It's literally like a true one-to-one, and that's why they charge you the $820. Well, the $1,000 now, but this is why. So that's actually a sketch of my shoe, and on the back, it actually has a rendered image of what my shoe looks like. So actually, you leave with this as well. I forgot that you walk out with this. This is just a standard sketchbook, and this is, my shoe's actually modeled after War Machine. So this is an Air Force One silhouette, and that's actually a War Machine coming out of like basically like the ice day to the toe cap, and it's just a sketch, and that's the only thing that's in there. The rest of the book is empty. But yeah, you leave with this, and that's just a sketch of your shoe. So this is the shoe tree that comes in it, and it's super heavy. Like, it's a legit shoe tree. It's got the chrome handle and the Nike sportswear wood burn into the back panel. This is a true 101. Nobody else can have it without my permission. The concept was War Machine, and I'll elaborate on that. So the reverse nubuck across the toe box, through the ice day, and through the back tab represents damage, like battle damage. That's what I replaced the elephant print with instead of using elephant print, was originally gonna be the concept for battle damage. I just used reverse nubuck. The patent leather, the two-tone patent leather, the patent leather here represents like the shiny part of the metal that hasn't been damaged. The double swoosh is 3M, so it's a teal 3M and then a gray 3M on top of it, and that's 3M, and that's what's represent his eyes. The tongue has no Nike tab or any tab at all, and that's supposed to be the power source that's in his chest. The Dubray actually says process, and I believe the left one says process as well. The back tab is just 3M, and it's oxidized now, but this was actually translucent, and the bottom of the shoe is painted blue, and the thought process is that it's like whenever they take off, the flames from their feet is blue. So when they would sit, it almost give it that hovering look. And that's why I chose the translucent sole, and that's to represent almost like the flight. All the eyelets are black. At the time, and I think you can buy them now, Mercer was the only place you could get wax laces. And at that time, you could put them on eBay and get $100 for them. Just for laces. Because at the time they were only available through 21 Mercer. The only thing that even represents the fact that it's Nike is the swoosh. And on the back, instead of having them put Nike or anything on it, I actually had them put HSK for the Heat Seakers Krew. Yeah, but that's that. It's a legit 101. At the time, it was 820. And it's literally, I'm not even an Air Force One, guys. It's only one of two Air Forces I own. The other one is the 112. But yeah, that's it, man. 101 Nike Bespoke War Machine, done by me.
All right, guys, we just got done with Process's top 10, man. That was probably like, for me, that I've never seen that many sample pairs in person, nor have I seen that many exclusive shoes like that. You see those every day, so it's nothing to you, but
for, sure, I'm in the closet.
for some of y'all out there, if y'all don't know, that is heat that my apartment almost caught fire on there. But I mean, yeah, well, if y'all want, just go ahead and give Process a follow. I'll go ahead and link it down below, and I just want to thank him for coming in. And
no problem, man. It was worth it, and I might do a top 10 just Air Max, so
maybe. All right, guys, so stay tuned, and
I'll be back.
Appreciate it, man. All right, thank you.